Hi everyone, this is going to be my Cabana Glama makeup tutorial. Oh, there's me without makeup. So the first thing we're going to do is, you should really probably put your hair back since we're going to be putting on, you know, face makeup and stuff like that. Don't want your hair on your face. Alright, let's go. Let's roll up the sleeves. And we're going to start off by using our L'Oreal Magic BB Cream. I'm using the shade medium. It's a pretty good match for me, but I suggest shaking it up because sometimes the beads can kind of separate. And I just always apply it on my fingers. You can of course use a brush or just apply it straight to a brush if you want to, but I just put it on my finger, dab it all over my face, everywhere, because the first thing we're going to do is we're going to first spread it out with our fingers because I feel like this helps to break up the beads a little bit. Because in case you haven't used this, it is kind of like a gritty texture almost, but I know it bothers some people. It doesn't bother me. I think it goes away really quickly. So you just take your fingers, and my fingers are clean. I washed them before I started putting my makeup on, and I just kind of just do a general spreading it out everywhere. But we're gonna really buff it in. We're gonna use a brush. But yeah, first I just like to use my fingers. I feel like it helps to warm up the product, and I feel like because it is kind of a thinner product, you're not really losing any of it by using your fingers. I know that bothers some people, but just get it everywhere. Make sure you get it, you know, under your chin. We're gonna buff it into the neck, and this is just like a flat, like foundation brush from a brand called Raw Color. I got it for only a couple dollars. Online from drugstore.com. I think it was like $5 or something like that, and it works really well. It's really dense and it's really soft, and it really buffs the foundation into the skin really nicely. And I know this isn't really a foundation, it's only a BB cream, but I have used this with like actual like full coverage foundations, and it works really nice for everything I've used it for. This is, you know, a light coverage, but this is, I was just going out for the day, so this, you know, wasn't really supposed to be like full coverage, just kind of trying to, you know, cover up any unevenness in the skin, a little bit of redness I had going on. Just buff that in really nice, and then we're going to get out the Cabana Glamour palette. I think I'm going to do a full review of this, and this is the Some Kind of Gorgeous. It's supposed to be, it's called a Foundation Faker, I think. Yes, it's a Foundation Faker. It's the medium one. I'm using it as a concealer and an eyeshadow primer. So, yep, just, I pat it first. You could see me doing it in the clip a couple seconds ago. I pat it first to help warm it up, and then really just swirl my finger into it and just swirl it into the face. You could use a brush if you wanted to. The product's so thin that I don't think you really need a brush for it, but, you know, it's up to your preference. Just put that everywhere. I'm only really showing you this one eye, but I did do it on both eyes. I think I clipped out the other one. Yes, so just smoothing everything out. I let it set for a minute. Dance for a second. All right, now back to the makeup. So I'm just taking a MAC 217 brush, and I'm gonna take the darkest color, darkest eyeshadow color. It is shimmery, but honestly, the shimmer doesn't transfer. It's not like super shimmery, so I just am using this, tapping it in, or, you know, putting it in the brush, tapping a little bit of excess off in case there was too much shimmer, and then I'm just putting it in the crease of both my eyes, really just to warm up my eye and help all my other colors just go a little bit faster. I think this, if you put your crease color down first, it helps the rest of your makeup, the rest of your eye makeup kind of go a little bit faster. Just doing that to both eyes, really working it in. And just taking a little bit more if you need it. It's not incredibly pigmented, I figured out. So it does take a little bit of work. And it's really only this dark one, the darkest color. The other two colors turned out pretty well. They're very pigmented. But this one just lacks a little bit for me, so I kind of had to work at it for a little bit harder than I did the other ones. And then I'm going to take just a little sponge applicator that comes with the Cabana Glamma palette, and I'm going in with the medium color. This is like the all-over lid color, or at least that's what I'm using it for. Just pack it onto your little sponge applicator. This also might have been why the color transferred a little bit more pigmented, because I did use the brush little sponge, and sponges tend to get a little bit more product. So just put that all over both lids. kind of, you know, you could blend it into the crease color a little bit with the sponge applicator. And, you know, you could build it to your intensity. I really like this color a lot. It's my favorite color of the three, so this is the color that I wanted the most prominent. So I did do a couple layers of it on both eyes. Then going in with the brush has two different sides, a thinner side and a thicker side. This is the thinner side. I'm going in to highlight my inner corners with this beautiful pink shade. I love it. I think it's so gorgeous. If they sold this one by itself, I would definitely buy it because it's so beautiful. And I'd say it's almost similar to Virgin from the Naked palette. It doesn't look like it at first, but when you swatch it, you get like that same beautiful sheen. And it's almost like if Virgin from the Naked palette and Sin from the Naked palette had a baby, that's what this color would be. And I really love it. I think it's gorgeous. And what I like to do with my inner corners, I like to really, really have a shimmery inner corner. And so what I'll do is I'll bring it all the way up into my inner crease, and then sometimes I'll even take my finger and apply a little bit more. But now I just took my finger, just got the tiniest bit on because it's really pigmented, and applied it to my as my brow highlight for both my eyes. And I also think I took a little bit more and just dabbed it right into the inner corners because your thumb, or not your thumb, your middle finger or ring finger, they're perfect for placing just right into the inner corners. And then I'm taking my MAC 217 brush again and just helping to blend out the colors, the crease color and the highlight color a little bit. So it's just kind of a smooth transition. Just blendy, 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 blendy. Alright, what am I going to do next? The next thing I'm going to do is taking this flat liner brush from Sephora. I think it was pretty affordable. Going with the darkest shade. I did actually have to work pretty hard in building this up because I had to do it several times, but I just, you know, clipped that out so that you guys wouldn't have to watch me doing it over and over again. And I do like to, I know a lot of people hate it, but I do like to pull my eyes because I do have hooded eyes, so it's hard for me. I have hooded eyes and I have really long lashes naturally, so it's really hard for me to get a really good line. So I do have to pull my eyes like that, and I am being very gentle, I promise. The only problems I ever have is sometimes I find that I mess up my makeup a little bit. I kind of smudge it around. So go in with that brown, that same brown, take a little bit more and put it on the lower lash line on both eyes. This looks really beautiful. It just helps to kind of naturally emphasize your lashes. And then I'm going back in with the, what is it called? Some kind of gorgeous foundation baker. I'm just kind of using it as a concealer. I have a couple sits, as you can see, and this really, it didn't cover the nits completely, but it really did help to cut out a lot of the redness that they had, especially the one that you can see on my cheek right there that I'm just patting in the foundation with my foundation brush again. And you couldn't hide it, but it did get rid of a lot of the redness, and this also helped to cover some of the redness. This is my Mineral Wear Correcting Face Powder from Physicians Formula. And I'm also using my Bare Minerals just full face brush and just kind of patting that into the skin and then kind of swirling it around and buffing it into the skin. Just swirly, swirly. Sorry if you can hear that. That's my very annoying. It's not actually my dog, it's my dad's very annoying dog. And she's old and senile, so she kind of makes noises at everything. So yeah, I spent there's the other dog. That's not the annoying one. That's just someone creeping. Oh, it's a creeper. And I really like to work a good amount of powder because I do get pretty oily, so I do have to set my foundation and concealer. And now I'm just taking my Revlon Brow Fantasy brush. This is like the double-sided. It has the pencil on one side and the gel on the other side. And this is the color, I think, dark brown or... Hold on one second. So yes, I do like kind of a stronger brow. Just because I don't know, I feel like it fits my face. I do have pretty naturally thick eyebrows, and I do like to set with the gel. I don't always do both. Sometimes I'll do just the gel, kind of if I'm in a more of a hurry or a pinch, but I had a good amount of time to get ready today, so I figured, oh, I'd set my brows. Yeah, this product's really convenient, and they have it for like a million colors. I really recommend it. And yeah, I love it. The pencil does go down pretty quickly though, because it is so soft. But just set the brows, shape them. And you could use a spoolie if you wanted to. I do use a spoolie just to kind of, I think this helps brush the gel kind of all the way through the hairs, because you don't want to take that gel and just kind of just blob it onto your eyebrows, because that might look a little bit like plasticky. So yeah, I just use a spoolie just to kind of help work that gel into the eyebrows. And then I'm taking the little brush that comes in the Cabana Glama palette and the Huda bronzer, and I'm using that to do a contour. And as you can see, the brush is very, very detailed. So I use it to do kind of like a very harsh line at first, and then afterwards it just kind of, I just use a bigger brush to blend it out. But I think the little brush that they come with is very usable. You could use it to blend it out, but I just chose to blend it out with a different brush because I had one, and you can't see right now because I'm terrible and cut my whole face out. But I was just kind of contouring my jaw, both sides of my cheeks, my nose a little bit, around my face. Just help bring a little bit of color, help to contour a little bit. And yeah, just applying a little bit more. I thought I needed a little bit more because I blend it out pretty sheerly. So yeah, that's why I apply it a little bit heavier at first, or so it looks a little bit heavier. But that line that you can see right there is totally going to be gone. But yep, I blended that all out. And now I'm taking my MAC blush in Poised. I'm not sure if this was permanent or not. I purchased it from the Absolute Strength collection, and I love it. It just has a little bit of shimmer to it. It's beautiful. And I blended my bronzer out with that same brush I was just using. And this is my Pixie highlighter. This is the number 3 shade. They have a whole bunch of different colors. It's good, you know. I think it's a little bit expensive. And I feel like you could find cheaper alternatives that are just as good. And since I had already kind of tapped it all over my finger, I just used my finger to apply it a little bit. And then I'm still going to take a brush, add a little bit more. I like to swirl any that's on the mirror. I like to swirl that off with my brush first. And then just get a little bit more product, and then just tap it back on into my mirror if there's any excess. That way I'm not really wasting any product, because this product does crumble very easily, which is something I don't really like about it. You know, it is very crumbly, and for being a more expensive product, I would expect a little bit higher quality, but it's okay. I got it on sale. I think it was about 50 or 75% off, but it does a nice job. And now we're getting close to finishing everything up. I am using the Revlon Just Bitten Balm Stain in Honey. If I apply this just one or two coats, kind of like I have right now, this is like my my lips but better color. I can apply it a little bit more, and I get a like very pretty pink color. Then I took my Ico liquid eyeliner. Oh, I had to get up for a second, but I took my Ico liquid eyeliner. And I just did the very outer corners because I felt like there wasn't enough definition there just from the shadow. Then I had to get up and go get my mascara because I forgot them in my room. Silly me. And applied one coat of each. The first one is my Maybelline Colossal Mascara, which I love, but it's the very end of its life and I have to throw it away. So I think I'm going to try the Cat Eyes one next because it looks really nice and I love the cheetah print on it. And then my Maybelline Lash Stiletto Mascara, which is great for length and to get that pretty separation and, you know, very doll-eyed. And I also put this one on my lower lashes, but I think I clipped it out too. So yep, some nice couple coats of mascara. You know, you could use whatever mascara you have. But, and then I'm taking my powder brush again. I'm just using this to kind of blend everything out, you know, just so that there's not too many harsh lines. You can't tell the bronzer from the blush from the highlighter. I just kind of want it to be very seamless. Then I just add a tiny bit more powder, and voila, I'm done. Bye, love you all.